I've recently seen a few videos on YouTube about gold diggers. You know those videos where a guy is hitting on a girl on the street and the girl gives him the cold shoulder until the guy comes back with a Lamborghini, and now the girl all of a sudden is very interested in the guy. Now, is that really true? Do women only care about money? In this video, I'm going to use scientific methods to see if it's actually true. To find out the truth, I went ahead and set up an experiment. An experiment that was scientifically valid. That means not just asking a couple of your girlfriends or a random interview on the street. Rather, I made sure that the experiment involved lots and lots of women. Not just a few, but hundreds. And then I needed to allow these hundreds of women to choose among men. There's a scientific approach, a statistical analysis technique called conjoint analysis. And conjoint analysis reveals people's preferences by analyzing the choices that they make. I use conjoint analysis to analyze women's choices and determine what type of man women would like to date. I created lots and lots of different imaginary men. These men were different on a couple of important characteristics, such as looks, physical attractiveness, height, employment, kindness, ambition, intelligence, sense of humor, and confidence. For every one of these attributes I just listed, I created men on a spectrum. For example, for looks I created physically unattractive men, fairly normal looking men, and ripped bodybuilder look. For height, there were short men 5'4", average 6 feet, and tall 6'3". Now for employment, and here's where money comes in, there were unemployed men, men who make $30,000 a year, $75,000 a year, $150,000 a year, and there were men who were millionaires. Each man was a random combination of these attributes. Maybe unattractive but kind, makes $75,000 a year, intelligence, has a great sense of humor. In the experiment, we showed women three men, each different on these attributes, and we asked the women to vote on the man that they would like to date out of these three. And this went on and on, vote after vote. Women saw hundreds of different combinations of men. Conjoint analysis was then used to find the patterns in these thousands of votes. I asked one of America's best known survey panel providers, Dynata, to send out this online survey to 200 randomly selected women. To make the conjoint analysis results easy to understand, Lighthouse Studio has a simulator and we'll use it to create a real world simulation. This real-world simulation will be a game, and let's call this game, which of these three guys would women choose? In the game, let's create three imaginary guys, Johnny, Buddy, and Jimmy, and these three guys are completely the same on all aspects. Average height, kindness, average intelligence, looks, average everything. Then we will change one characteristics about one of the guys, say Johnny, and we'll see how that affects the chances of these guys being picked by women. Ready? Let's go. Because Johnny, Buddy, and Jimmy are completely the same on all aspects, each has exactly a 1 in 3 chance of being picked. As a percentage, Johnny has a 33% chance of being selected, and so do the other two. But how would Johnny's chance of being picked change if he was shorter, if he was 5'4" instead of 6 feet? Based on the data analyzed from using 200 women using conjoint analysis, Johnny now has a 21% chance. Okay, so let's go back to making them even again, and this time what if Johnny was more intelligent? Increasing Johnny's intelligence would also indeed increase his chances from 33% to 40%, or 4 out of 10 women would pick Johnny. What about humor? Turns out being funny does increase your chances with women. Very funny Johnny would attract 43% of the women now. The other two would only attract 28% each. Apparently humor is more attractive than intelligence. Okay, so now let's talk about money. If all else being equal, except Johnny was unemployed, while the other two guys have an average paying job, how would that affect Johnny's chances? Johnny's chances would plummet. Only 9 out of 100 women would care to date unemployed Johnny. Now let's look at the flip side. What if Johnny had a job that pays nicely above the average? Well, he does have a much better chance now. 44% of the women would pick Johnny. That also means that 56% of the other women would not pick Johnny. Okay, surely if we make Johnny a millionaire, do we see all the women pick Johnny? Johnny had a 44% chance with the women with a well-paying job, And now as a millionaire, he would have a 48% chance. Or we can also say the inverse, that 52% of the women would not care that he is a millionaire. So what's the big takeaway? It is that women only care that you have a job, that you're not unemployed. After that, the majority of women do not care if you're a millionaire. So far, having a job seems to be the most important characteristic, but is it the most important? What if all else equal, we made Johnny very unattractive? Do women care about your looks? Well, yes, they do. Very unattractive Johnny would only be picked by 5 out of 100 women. The other two guys would get the other 95 women. Okay, so let's see if ugly Johnny can make up for his ugliness with money. Let's make ugly Johnny a millionaire. Surely that would bring him up to the level of the other two guys, right? Wrong. Turns out women don't want unattractive, even if he's a millionaire. Ugly Johnny went from a 5% of a chance to now a 7% of a chance. Not much of an improvement. The myth that women would go with just about anyone for money has been busted, or scientifically disproved. So what is the most important attribute? Well, we haven't looked at kindness. Let's go back to all things being equal and let's make Johnny a very kind and patient person, while the other two are just average. Johnny's chances are now 64%, while the other two drop to 18% each. Wow, that's a huge advantage. Let's stay here for a second and now let's also make Jimmy a rude person. Now Johnny has a 72% chance and Jimmy's chance plummeted to only 5%. That's a huge difference. Kindness, probably a surprise to many men, but likely unsurprising to most women, has proven to be the most attractive feature about men. The problem is that everyone is kind on the first date. But if you are truly a genuinely kind and loving person as a character trait, that is the most attractive feature. In fact, this is how important kindness is. Even if you have a job that pays below the average money, but a genuinely kind and loving person, 53% of the women would still prefer you versus the other two guys with better paying jobs. This is not an opinion, it's based on a scientific study. How important is kindness? Even if you're 5'4" and the other two guys are 6 feet, if you have a kind and loving character, while the other two guys are just average, 42% of the women would pick you. So based on a study of 200 American women of all races, incomes, marital status, using conjoint analysis, what are the top 5 most important characteristics about men to be attractive? Number 5 is intelligence. Number 4 is humor. Number 3 is employment or wealth. Number 2 is looks and physical attractiveness. And number 1 is kindness of character. Well, there you have it. Based on a scientific analysis of 200 women's choice patterns, we can say that women are waiting for a man who is employed, who is physically attractive, and most importantly, they're waiting for a man with a kind character. While conjoint analysis is a very complex statistical procedure, it's safe to say that women are 100 times more complex. Of course, there are other aspects that influence attraction, like personal chemistry, common goals, or even a smell of a cologne. The purpose of this video was to illustrate how a concept such as attraction can be deconstructed using conjoint analysis. I encourage you to think about the great value conjoint analysis can have in understanding people's preferences, whether it's about dating or more commonly about products or services. Hope you enjoyed it. See you next time.